know the restrictions.
It's a discman. He plays music. Neil Diamond. No restrictions against listening to Neil Diamond, are there?
Yeah. Greatest hits? What does it have coming to America?
I don't know. I just bought it.
Nick. When on earth did you ever start smoking, buddy?
I do a lot of things since Patricia's gone.
Sorry.
Coffee 0939. Noted.
Hey, Stu, come and check this out. We've got a security alert. Follow procedure C. C for Charlie.
This is a code 2 alert. All personnel evacuate the building immediately. Do not use the elevators. Proceed to the nearest exit. This is not a drill.
Check it out.
on.
Hey, what is it, a bomb?
Busted a window in your new car.
My Mustang, shit! Idiot.
Downloaded the codes, and I'm ready to remove the decrypting chip. Punch in the systems.
Shut down security codes for Station 11.
This should take about a minute.
Code to alert is now canceled. All personnel, you are clear to return to your workstation. Code to alert is now canceled. All personnel, you are clear to return to your workstation.
Bring up 11?
Goddamn, look at Constantin. He's already back to work. He's been like a bloody robot since this wife passed away.
This is Unit 1, we're all clear here.
Thank you.
happening?
Nice makeup job.
Thank you, Robin.
You look like you're getting ready to go to the Miss Trailer Park pageant.
Now. I don't make fun of the way you dress. Besides, it's way too early for ridicule.
Early?
Well, it's early for me. I didn't get home till the crack of dawn. Wait a second. How come you're not at school?
Spring break?
All right. That starts today, doesn't it?
Yeah. So does gymnastics.
I knew that.
Then I suppose you also know that you promised me a ride?
Not again.
It's only a tremor, Mom. There's been two other ones this morning. I thought you said you were gonna quit.
He did. For a while.
Another broken promise.
Hand him over. Listen, I can't give you a ride this morning. I know I promised, but I can't.
No, surprise, surprise.
Now, the common misconception is that these plates move in opposite directions, but it's more accurate to say that there is a constant and building tension between these plates. They're always pushing against each other. So what happened this morning was that we had a release of that tension.
What does that mean in terms of what we can expect as far as tremors or even earthquakes are concerned?
Well, Sarah, a number of tremors is actually a good thing. It's a small release of tension over a period of time, as opposed to a major earthquake.
Which is still a possibility.
How about one of the other mothers gives you a lift?
One of the other mothers is always giving me a lift. It's embarrassing.
Wait a minute. Robin, I know things have been tough on you, but it's all gonna be over soon.
You've been saying soon all year. That's why Dad moved to Los Angeles.
Enough.
I hate this car.
I said that's enough. It's part of my undercover character. It's my job. I'm sorry I can't be like all those other mothers.
I don't want you to be like those other moms. I just want you to be my mom.
Hello, Mrs. Bauer. Hi, it's Amanda. Amanda? Amanda Foster. Robin's mother? Yeah. Look, I'm in a bit of a bind. I'm wondering if you could do me a really big favor.
I thought you quit, Roxy.
Just shut up and give me the pass, guys.
Thank you very much.
Been waiting for a call.
Dimitri, it's going down now?
Mm-hmm. Ivan, our computer specialist is here. Give her the address. My brother Ivan, he loves America. Very sophisticated, very smooth. He wants to be Rock Hudson.
In a pillow talk, Rock Hudson, очень star, very big.
Oh, my brother. I tell Ivan, Rock had more balls on his chin than American baseball catcher.
This, I do not believe.
He's clean.
Do you have the disc? You made the connection?
Yes.
Good day, Tanya.
Good day. Everything's ready for transmission.
I'm very glad. Please continue.
Give me one moment and I will send it.
Whenever you're ready.
Send it through. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What is this?
Are you trying to be funny? What's going on? You said...
What I said was that I'd give you Globotech's new stealth aircraft tracking system for $15 million. And that's what you've got. You have the schematics. You just can't see them.
No, I do not see any tracking system. I see... bunnies.
Easter bunnies. That's Globotech's encryption system. That's pretty cool, huh? Changes with every season. You'll need a microchip to decipher what I just gave you.
Where is this chip?
Somewhere safe. You'll have it as soon as I get my 15 million.
The deal is, I give you 5 now. The other 10, when I see the information is good.
The ability to track a stealth aircraft anywhere in the world is worth a damn sight more than $15 million. I could probably find a nation that'll pay $100 million or more. My guess is you guys already have. Now, all I want is my tidy little profit. But make no mistake, I want it all. And I want it now.
People do not alter deals with me, Mr. Constantin.
Globotech has spent 5 years and all its money on this project. They are going to be crushed.
Now they, nor U.S. intelligence, are going to take this lying down. They're going to be sniffing me out all over the globe. But hey,
I don't mind a life on the run, but not without my paycheck. I want $15 million in my Swiss account right now.
Ivan? I want the chip now.
Tanya,
we will honor
Mr. Constantine's request. I will transfer the money now.
Account number and password.
Account number 4362143 Bravo Alpha Romeo. Roth Royal Bank of Zurich.
Password?
Excuse me. Okay, come on. Fill her up.
Okay, the chip.
It's not that easy. I'll ring you 5 minutes after I leave the building. 15 million is not gonna do me a lot of good with a bullet in my head.
Mr. Constantine, if by chance
we do not receive that microchip,
there will be no excuses. If you are mugged on your way out, if you get hit by a cable car, if you are attacked and torn to pieces by a pack of wild dogs, it will not matter. I can assure you that everyone sharing your last name shall suffer the most extreme retribution.
5 minutes.
Yeah. 5 minutes. Ciao, everybody.
Thank you.
Where is it?
It's in a phone box at the corner of Hickory and...
Freeze! FBI.
Where's Roxy?
Keep your hands where I can see them.
Roxy's FBI.
You're under arrest for espionage.
Hickory and Riviera.
They're right around the corner.
Move!
The phone booth. Hickory and Riviera. Go.
Please, let's go!
Remove your ass!
Appreciate your cooperation.
Well, whatever we can do to help. Obviously, this can have a huge effect on the future of global tech. We have to find this chip.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Thank you for coming. The raid this morning, unfortunately, turned up nothing. The strip bar was cleared bare, not even prints. It would appear they had a cleaning team. Now, we have men stationed at the airport. These guys aren't stupid. It's very possible they'll slip across the border into Canada. And from there, who knows?
No. They're still here. They wouldn't leave without the chip. Where it goes, they'll follow. Nick Constantine is the only one that knows where it is. I get it from him, they come to me.
My boys have tried everything to get it out of him, Amanda, and he doesn't give a damn. Excuse me. Could we have 5 minutes, please? Thank you. Maybe LA will have better luck with him.
LA?
He flies out in an hour.
What's going on here, Ted?
I'm not sure.
I've been deep cover for a year. I deserve to know.
Word is there's a breach of security. I'm told our safe houses have been compromised. San Francisco is no longer a safe place to hold him.
A breach here in FBI?
Yeah, it's real hush-hush. Orders are to bring him to a safe house in LA, and that's coming straight from the top. Special Agent Moore. And Moore himself is going to take custody of Constantine in L.A. They've got a new safe house there. They want to get him the hell out of the city. Moore's orders.
I'll escort Constantine there.
No. It's all been settled, Amanda. I'm sorry. You shouldn't be smoking in here.
You're sorry? I shouldn't be smoking? I've been undercover for a year. My marriage is a disaster. My daughter thinks that I've abandoned her. And the moment this case takes a turn for the worse, you dump me?
That's not the way it is. You're not being dumped. The case is just being taken over from above.
Then let me escort him there. You can do that for me.
It's just way too complicated at this point.
Don't tell me that you can't, because you and I both know that you can.
All right.
Sweetie, I need to talk to you. Honey, I was thinking you could stay with Patty. Robin? Robin! Robin, are you in here? Is she? I'm coming.
Steven, are you there?
I know you're there.
There's someone here who'd like to talk to you.
Mom? Robin? Robin? What are you doing in Los Angeles?
I was worried about you.
All you're ever worried about is work.
I've decided something.
I'm not gonna live with you anymore. I'm gonna live with Dad.
You will do no such thing!
You can't tell me what to do anymore.
Look, can we just get together and talk, please? You and I, woman to woman, I know we can sort this whole thing out.
Let's just get together and talk.
Yeah, I've heard it all before.
Look, I know, but I mean it this time. I'm coming to Los Angeles.
Just pick a place, anywhere you like.
There's no point. You're just gonna find some excuse not to show.
Please, honey.
Trust me.
9 o'clock at the Bean Queen. It's a coffee shop in Angel City Mall.
Okay. I know where that is. I'll see you tonight, okay?
Agent Foster.
Blimey. A Learjet. Nice transportation.
I guess it pays being a criminal nowadays.
You know, Miss Foster, your new look is, simply marvelous. I had no idea earlier that there was such a stunning woman beneath that vulgar facade.
It's Mrs. Foster, Mr. Constantine.
Really? You don't look like the marrying kind.
And you don't know anything about me, Mr. Constantine. Maybe you don't understand the seriousness of your situation. There's no way out. But you can start by telling me where the microchip is.
Now, why would I do that?
Why don't you try entering your password?
Why?
So you believe me when I tell you that I've changed it? You give me the chip, I give you the password.
You do understand, Agent Foster, that giving you that chip is tantamount to swallowing a cyanide capsule. The only reason that I'm still alive is because I have something that Dimitri wants. That chip is my life insurance. And besides, you don't play nice.
This is Leslie Michaels on KTSL News Radio, where you get traffic and weather updates every 15 minutes. And now here's Nancy Dotton up in Chopper 3 with the latest in traffic. How are the freeways looking, Nancy?
Thanks, Leslie. Things are moving right along on many major routes with the exception of PCH, where a three-car pileup has closed two lanes, one in either direction. Right now I'm flying over downtown. School's out today and traffic is light. No reports of any major tie-ups. As always, watch out for speed traps and stay tuned to KTSL, where every 15 minutes, traffic updates are coming to you live. From your eye in the sky, me, Nancy Dotson.
Thanks, Nancy. Now a word from tryitall.com, where you can get anything you want.
We're a little early, aren't we?
No, I'm meeting Brad first, so if Mom doesn't show up, at least I haven't wasted my time.
Who's Brad?
You know, Brad from swimming.
Oh, swimming Brad. He lives in L.A. now?
No, he's visiting his dad. Ironic, isn't it?
Robin, try to be nice when you see her. She's not the enemy. She loves you.
I doubt she'll even show up. Thanks, Dad.
Sooner or later, Dimitri's gonna make a move against you. It's possible that my guard might be down. A stray bullet could make it through to you, Nick. Am I making myself perfectly clear? I want that chip.
You don't know anything about me.
Actually, I know quite a bit about you. Nicholas Ryan Constantine, age 30. Military systems designer for Global Tech. Recruited straight out of college. Our profile shows you to be an unlikely traitor.
You know about my wife?
Patricia.
It was leukemia. Do you also know that she was my high school sweetheart? That she was my best friend?
How do you think your best friend would feel about you selling out her country?
I'm doing this to destroy my company, not this country.
All the same, that's the eventuality.
So be it.
What do you have against Global Tech?
Like I said, you really don't know anything about me.
This isn't the way to the federal building. Where are we going?
Change in plans.
Who authorized it?
Agent Moore. He's waiting for you at a secure location. But don't worry, we're just being careful. The security team is waiting at the location and will remain with you at all times.
Hey, Brad.
Hiya. You got a belly thing there, huh?
Oh, yeah. I got it, like, 2 weeks ago.
I thought your mom said you couldn't have one.
She didn't even notice.
Well, it's the same old, isn't it?
Yeah, same old, same old. You know, I actually got it to piss her off. It didn't work.
Yeah, I know the drill. Hey, do you want to go to the observation deck with me? I hear you can see the whole city.
Sure. But I gotta be back at the Bean Queen by 9.
Yeah, no problem. Let's
All right.
go.
Agent Foster?
Yes.
Agent Moore's waiting for you. If you follow me, please, I'll take you right to him.
Agent Moore.
Agent Foster. Certainly is a pleasure to meet you.
This is Nick Constantine.
Nick.
Agent Moore.
I thought we were meeting at the federal building.
Been a little slight change in plans. Please have a seat.
This is us. Seventh floor, right? Yeah. You're one different floor?
Fifth floor, please.
The more you push the button, the faster the elevator goes. Little trick I picked up.
L.A. Public Schools. Oh, my.
Ooh, things sure have heated up over at the agency. About an hour ago, they busted a double agent who was working as a mole.
I heard about that up in San Francisco.
Krinicki.
Krinicki?
Yeah. Does that ring a bell, Nick? I believe he's the one who cleared the alarm system for you.
Boy, you guys are sharp. I never even met the guy. I have no idea who he is. Dimitri set it up.
Well, he sure as hell knows who you are. As a matter of fact, he's cutting a deal for himself right now. At your expense.
Then I guess I'm in a bit of a pickle, huh?
You see, Agent Foster, that's why I wanted to have our little meeting here. I hope you don't mind. You see, Nick, the agency has been known to help people out now and then. Of course, he'd have to show us a little cooperation, wouldn't you say?
Of course. The chip.
The chip. The chip, of course. What else?
Why don't you just tell us where it is, Nick?
Because if I do, I'm a dead man.
I see. Well, I guess you are in a bit of a pickle, my friend.
Well, I guess this would be a good time to call my attorney. Agent Foster, your cell phone, if you please.
Thank you. through this time.
Are you nuts?
I'm the only chance you got, Nick.
You almost shot me!
We're alive. We didn't die.
Not yet, we didn't. I hate to bring ants to your picnic, kids, but there's still plenty that can go wrong. Plenty. There's a good chance we'll never get out of this elevator alive, you know.
Anyway, thanks for the update.
Name's Patrick. Pat's fine, too. Pat Corso. And I like birds, okay?
Dear Agent Foster, I guess the big one finally hit, huh?
I'd say you guessed right. Go on. Look around and see if we can find another way out of here.
Yes, ma'am.
What do you see?
Can't see a bloody thing.
Idiot!
You ruined my plan.
Sounds like your FBI buddy.
Shh.
If you ask me, they're probably halfway to the federal building by now.
So what the hell are you doing here? Let's go.
Dan, this place is gonna fill up fast.
I think they're gone.
Come on, we need to get out of here. Ah, it must be blocked. Shit. We gotta find a way out.
You should come down from there, Missy. You're gonna hurt yourself. We should wait for the proper authorities to come and rescue us. Yeah, I mean, they could level all sorts of charges, you know.
Mr. Corsi, we have to get out of here now.
The hell was that?
God damn it! This thing's going nowhere.
Let's try that one.
Come on.
What's going on?
I got a bad feeling about this.
Yeah, me too. Come on, you jump up. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Damn it!
Come on, you're going to take off these paths. Come on, you've got to get out that window. Smash the window. Come on.
Okay, Mr. Corsi, your turn.
I don't know. This could be very hurtful.
Harry, you gotta get out of there now!
Unbelievable. I can't believe we even survived it. Oh, give it a rest. I just saved your life. Is this how you show your gratitude?
I'm just doing my job. You're still a spy.
You're never gonna make it stick. You have no hard evidence. It's all circumstantial. You don't have a copy of the stolen plans. You don't have the chip. I'm the only one you got in custody. I'm probably gonna walk away with a slap on the wrist.
There'll still be a hit out on you, Nick.
They're gonna kill you too. Where are we going anyway?
North. We're heading to the mall. We've got to find my daughter, Robin. Go on. Now!
Whatever.
Am I on? Are we hot? I'm sorry, Leslie? I can't hear you anymore. To folks listening, this is Nancy Dotson with continuous coverage of the largest earthquake in Los Angeles City history. Gas mains have broken everywhere, and from my view here, there are more fires than I can count. The city of Los Angeles has been declared a disaster area. National Guard is being deployed, but it will take anywhere from 1 to 3 days to get it completely mobilized. The view is... This is more than I could describe. Reporting live, this is Nancy Dotson with KTSL News Radio.
Daddy, come on.
What are you doing?
I suggest you stop yelling at me, Tanya. Agent Foster's phone.
Who's speaking? Where's my wife?
Mr. Foster, this is Agent Moore.
Your wife is fine. There's been a little confusion down here at the federal building.
But everyone's fine. Is there a message I can give to her?
Yeah. Tell her to go to the mall, and I'll be waiting at home in case Robin comes here.
Robin?
She's waiting for her there. Maybe Amanda's headed there already.
And what mall would that be, Mr. Foster?
Angel City Mall.
Angel City Mall. I'll give her the message right away. Thank you.
What?
We're going shopping.
Where are you going?
I gotta get him some help. Easy.
There's no one to help you here.
I know. My mom's gonna meet me here at 9. She'll know what to do.
What makes you think she's gonna show up?
Nothing. I'm just hoping she will. Good luck.
You too, dear.
I hate Global Tech so much.
They killed my wife.
Your wife died of leukemia, Nick.
They let her die.
I'm sorry. You're gonna have to explain it to me because I just don't get it.
I spent countless hours designing and conceiving systems for them. I gave them my life.
Yeah, and you were well paid for it.
I worked my ass off for it. I earned every damn penny. I was actually doing something for national security, for this country.
Funny, I'm in the same damn business.
Yeah, and when I needed some help, they wouldn't lift a finger. Billions spent to safeguard this country's way of life. But hey, just don't get sick, because you're on your own.
What are you trying to tell me, that Global Tech didn't have a health plan?
Oh yeah, they had a health plan. Covered everything and anything. We tried all the traditional procedures, but nothing was working. So we opted for a new experimental treatment. Global Tech's medical, they wouldn't pay for it. We spent our life savings sending Patricia to England for treatment. I even mortgaged my house. I was spending so little time at work, those fucking bastards actually demoted me. And then when I asked them for a little bit of financial help, no way. Eventually the money ran out. And the time ran out.
I'm sorry for your loss.
Last month, the FDA approved the treatment. If we had started it when she was diagnosed, there's a 75% chance she would have made it. Global Tech invested everything into this system. Once this chip gets onto the black market, the technology becomes obsolete.
and Global Tech falls.
Touché?
Yeah, touché.
I can understand how you've come to hate them, Nick. But you're jeopardizing national security. You're using a sledgehammer to squash a fly.
It's called collateral damage, Amanda. It's an unfortunate but accepted evil in the defense industry. Look, I don't care about the money. I don't even care that you got the password. The first chance I get, this chip will get out.
I'm sorry, Nick. I can't let you do that.
Hey, give me a hand here. We got people that's still alive.
Stick it in your ass.
Please.
Oh, my God. We've got to help them.
How do you know I won't run off?
I don't. But I'm trusting you.
You sure you want to do that?
I don't have a choice.
Somebody secure that truck! There's people trapped down here!
Did you hear that?
FBI, please, everybody just step back. Thank you.
Without a mother.
Look, I just want you
hey,
to know I...
don't get all mushy on me, okay? It wasn't all that noble. I still want the password.
Right. Over here. Careful.
How can I have the password?
I thought you said this wasn't about money.
It's not about the money. Well, it's a little bit about the money.
All right, then. I'll give you the 15 million and you give me the chip.
And I want a kiss.
Would you just quit messing around, Nick? It's not funny anymore. Just tell me where it is. I give you the code, you go get the money, you take off to some deserted island somewhere, and you live happily ever after. I mean, it's a lot of dough, Nick. You could live a couple lifetimes easily on that much money.
You think so, huh?
Most people could live comfortably on 2 million, let alone 15 million.
You think my revenge can be bought off like some kind of gambling debt?
That's not what I'm saying.
Are you saying that my wife's life is worth $2 million? Would you trade your daughter's life for $2 million? How about 15 or even 30? Tell me, am I getting warm?
Enough. That's not what I'm saying. I'm just trying to tell you that you're not the only person in the world that's ever lost somebody that they really love. Let it go. Here it is. It's on the third level. She's gonna be up there somewhere. But how do we get there? Come on, Brad. Hang in there.
You got a really nice smile, you know that?
Come on. It's probably the only nice part about me right now.
Please, you look nice all the time.
So, how come you never asked me to go to a movie with you or something?
Whenever I hinted on it, you went all Darth Maul on me or something.
What?
It's true. You were kind of a chump to me.
I guess I just never realized.
There's a time when I didn't even want to talk to you.
So, why now?
I don't know. I guess everyone deserves another chance.
Mom, this is Brad. He's hurt. I think we should probably get him to a hospital or something.
Nick, this is my daughter, Robin. You want to give us a hand?
Shit! Nice to see that everybody made it to the party. In one piece. I trust. You held out, Nick.
Yeah, I got the chip.
Good. Why don't you just give it to me and I'll be on my way.
First, I want your assurance that you're gonna let Mander and the kids go.
Nick, I just want the chip.
You make a good liar, Moore. Both you and I know that everybody here can ID you. first let them go. Then you got the chip, and you got me.
I've never killed anyone before. But today could be my day.
Don't listen to him, Nick.
Give me the chip.
Don't do it, Nick.
This must be your lovely daughter, Robin.
I want that chip! All right! It's in the temple.
Can you find the Angel City Morgue?
Yeah.
I have Constantin, Agent Foster, and her lovely daughter, Robin.
Are they dead?
No, not yet.
Where's the chip?
The chip is in a safe place. Took a little more legwork than I anticipated, Dimitri. I trust I'll be well compensated.
You'll get what's coming to you.
I want $30 million.
You want 30 million?
Yes, 30 million.
As I said, you'll get what's coming to you. Kill them all!
Let's split up, we'll draw their fire.
Don't move! Don't move!
Thank you for everything you've done for me.
Like I said, we can't have Robin growing up without her mom. So what's next?
Gonna go file the longest report in history. I'm not looking forward to it either. Especially the part about how you got away while my back was turned. Don't you want the password?
I already know it.
No, you don't.
It's Robin. R-O-B-I-N.
Wrong. R-O-B-Y-N. Hey. I'm gonna miss you, Mr. Constantine.
I'm gonna miss you too, Mrs. Foster.
What do you say we go home?
As long as we don't take an elevator.
You read my mind.
Let's get out of here.